Hey everyone, here from Tunnel Vision TV, and I've decided I'm going to do a tutorial series on Adobe Premiere Pro, and I'm just going to go from start to finish, how to customize your interface, how to do your editing, right through to exporting your final video for uploading to YouTube, etc. So in this first video, I'm just going to concentrate on the layout or the interface inside of Premiere Pro. And for this series, I'm going to be using Premiere Pro 2017, but you should be able to follow along if you're using previous or other versions. It's very similar. Some of the things might be slightly different, but you should be able to follow along. So first time when you open up Premiere, you're going to start with an interface that looks something like this. And I'm going to show you guys how to just customize this. I like to just remove some of the panels and just to make it a little bit simpler, a little bit more cleaner. So first of all, go to Window right at the top, go to Workspaces, and then make sure that you're on the Editing workspace. It's just going to remove this panel on the side. And then I'm going to show you how to customize it even a little bit further. So you've got these panels open, and here at the bottom on the left hand side, you've got all these tabs like Project, Media Browser, etc. And what I like to do is I like to take this project window, so just click and drag on it, and then drag it right to the side of your monitor, and you'll see that it's going to snap this project panel right to the side. And then you can resize it, so I'm just going to resize it, make it smaller, something like this. And then I'm going to take my effects panel. So if you look here at the bottom, you'll see effects. If you click on this, I'm going to click and drag this to the bottom of my project window. So it's kind of sitting here at the bottom. I'm going to resize it so it's slightly smaller. And then Media Browser, Libraries, Info, Markers, and History. I'm going to remove these. So I'm going to right click on Media Browser, click on Close Panel. Do the same with Libraries, Info, also Close, Markers, Close, History, Close. All right, so now you've got your project section or your project panel here on the side. You've got your source window, you've got your program window, your timeline or your sequence, and you've got your tools, and then you've got your effects here at the bottom. Now, right at the top, you've got this assembly, editing, color, effects. This is basically just a workspace shortcut, and I'm going to close that as well because it's just taking up some extra space of the screen. So I'm going to right click here on the side, and then I'm just going to select close panel. All right, so that's gone. So let's quickly go through all these panels and I'll tell you what they do. So let's start with the project panel. So this is basically where you're gonna have all your media, all your video clips, your music, your sound effects, your photos, etc. That will be in this panel. And then you've got your source window. So your source window is basically, if you open up a clip from the project window, it's going to appear in the source window, and this is where you're going to preview it basically before you take it into your edit. And this is where you're going to set your in and out point, and then you're going to drag it into your sequence. So it's basically like a preview window before you actually start editing on or using that clip in your edit. Next you have your program window, and this will show the final output from your sequence. So if you're working or as you're working on your edit, you will see the video inside your program window. Right, then you've got your timeline or your sequence, and this is where you're going to be able to do your editing. You're going to be cutting your video clips here, you're going to add video clips, add your music, all of that. So you'll see when we start doing the first edit that those clips will appear in this section here at the bottom. And then you've got your tools. So we're going to go through these tools later, but this is basically your select and your razor tool, etc. And then you've got your effects here at the bottom. So this is like your audio effects and your video effects. And you'll also find your transitions, your video transitions and your audio transitions here. And that's basically all the panels that we're going to be using. Also, you're on the side, you've got your audio preview. This is where you're going to be seeing the audio levels of your video. So that's basically the layout that we're going to be using throughout this series. Make sure you set it up something like this, and then I'll see you guys in the next video.